thing that's going wrong with it is two things, in my honest opinion. The first thing is this. In pro wrestling, in my era, when you got broken, they beat me up bad and consistently for a long period of time. Are you aware of a hole called the sugar hole?
Yep.
Okay, so you know the blood comes out of the eyes and all that. And they'd count and cut your breath off, and they'd count 15, 14, you'd pass out. And then they'd keep you in it, but they'd let you breathe, and then they'd say, okay, I'm going to cut you off. And they'd be like for a half hour every day. And it was so mean, I thought. You know, and I suffered the consequence. Here's the point. They got guys that are opening up MMA gyms and just teaching anybody. And if you've got a guy that's just even half an athlete and he practices under a good coach for a month, or excuse me, for a year, he's going to have some kind of skill. Then that same idiot is getting drunk in a bar and using those skills. And that's the mistake that's accidentally been made. Matt Lindland is a great friend. My Brock Lesnar, Randy Couture, they trained my son. And it got out of their control. They're great men. They would never allow that. So, but who tells me people like that are in bouncers, in like in Vegas?
Right.
All of a sudden you get three or four guys and they, you know, get alcohol guts and they're doing it. That's the one. The second thing that I think that they're doing wrong, and they're doing so much right, I'm being really picky here because I got great respect for them, is when they're training for a fight, they're training like as they get close to it, no headgear on it. The amount of punishment that they're taking to train for the fight, it's killing their longevity, you know. But nobody has a handbook on it. And they're all the guys are doing the best they can.